continue our lesson for cubic function. The general form of cubic function is fx equal to ax cubed plus bx squared plus cx plus d. If fx equal to ax cubed and a greater than 0, the inflection point is at 0, 0. At the right, the graph is concave up and at the left is concave down. For the second graph, if fx equal to ax cubed plus d and a less than 0, the inflection point at d, 0d. At the right, the graph is concave down and at the left is concave up. The domain of the both function is negative infinity to infinity. And the range of both function also negative infinity to infinity. Next, for fx equal to ax cubed plus bx squared plus cx plus d and a less than 0, the graph cubic function is S-shaped and the inflection point at D at the right is concave down and at the left is concave up. For the second function, if fx equal to ax cubed plus bx squared plus cx plus d and a greater than 0, the inflection point at d at the right is concave up and at the left is concave down. Therefore, the domain of the both function is from negative infinity to infinity and the range of the both function also from negative infinity to infinity. For example 5.5, sketch the graph of the following functions, hence find its domain and range, given fx equal to x cubed plus 3. Therefore, the value of a is positive, greater than 0. For cubic function, inflection point at 0, 3. To sketch the graph cubic, x-axis, y-axis and inflection point at 0, 3. At the right, the graph is concave up and at the left is concave down. And label the graph fx equal to x cubed plus 3. The domain and the range of the cubic function is negative infinity to infinity. For example 5.5, question C, given fx equal to x squared times 2 minus x. If we expand the function, fx equal to negative x cubed plus 2x squared. That means the constant is 0. Therefore, the inflection point at 0, 0. The value of a is less than 0. To sketch the graph cubic, first step, find the y-axis, intercept y-axis at 0 and intercept x-axis from the function x squared times 2 minus x equal to 0, x equal to 0 and x equal to 2. we can sketch the graph cubic. The inflection point at 0, 0, intercept x-axis at 0 and 2, and the value of a less than 0. That means at the right, the graph is concave down, and at the left is concave up. Now, label the graph fx equal to x squared times 2 minus x. The domain and the range of the cubic function is negative infinity to infinity. For example, 5.5 question D, given fx equal to x cubed minus x squared minus 6x plus 2. Therefore, the value of a is greater than 0. And the constant term d equal to 2. To sketch the graph cubic, first, determine the intercept y-axis at 2. And to find intercept x-axis, x cubed minus x squared minus 6x plus 2 equal to 0. It's so you can use the calculator. From calculator, we can find the value of x1 is negative 2.2, x2 0.3, and x3 2.9. Now we can try to sketch the graph cubic. Plot the inflection point. Inflection point at 0, 2. Refer the constant term. At 0, 2. And intercept x-axis at negative 2.2, 0.3, and 2.9. When the value of a greater than 0, the graph at the right is concave up. And at the left is concave down. And we label the graph fx equal to x cubed minus x squared minus 6x plus 2. And the domain and the range of the cubic function is from negative infinity to infinity. Final for the lecture 1, give exercise. The question is, sketch the graph of the following functions, hence state the domain and range. Given question A, fx equal to negative 7 over 3. Question B, fx equal to 2x plus 5. And question C, fx equal to negative x squared plus 2x minus 1. You can try this question and you can discuss with your lecturer. Okay, thank you.
Set functions. Set is represented by this symbol. Or some of you may know this one as square root, right? For the set functions, we have lot of graph. For the first one, on the left-hand side here, the first graph is fx equals to zx. And I would like to include x greater than or equals to 0, because under the set, we cannot have negative number, or the least value we can have under the set is 0. Okay. From here, it tells you the graph is going to the right, and at the front of the set here, you may see they don't have symbols, or simply I would say it's positive because of the no symbols here or positive here, the graph is going up. For the domain, the smallest value it can have is 0, and the highest value it can have is infinity. For the range, the smallest value is 0 and the highest value is infinity. For the second graph, we have fx equals to negative zx. Again, I include x greater than equals to 0. Because of this one, it tells you the graph is going to the right, and because of the negative sign at the front of the set, the graph is going down, as shown by the red line. For the domain, the smallest value is 0 and the highest value is infinity. And for the range, the smallest value is negative infinity and the highest value is 0. For the third graph, we have here fx equals to x set x plus a, and I will include x plus a greater than equals to 0, and we have x greater than equals to negative a. So here we have negative a, so because of that we have negative a over here. And again, we have greater than or equal here. It tells you the graph is going up, or no, going to the right. And because of the symbols at the front here, positive or no symbol, the graph is going up. For the domain, the smallest value is negative a, and the highest value is infinity. And for the range, the smallest value is 0, and the highest value is infinity. For the third graph, we have fx equals to negative set x minus a, and I will include x minus a greater than equals to 0, so x greater than or equals to a. So we have a here, that's why we have a here. Because of greater than or equal here, so we have our graph going to the right, and because of the negative sign at the front of the set, our graph is going down. For the domain, the smallest value is a and the highest value is infinity. And for the range, the smallest value is negative infinity and the highest value is 0. For the next graph, we have fx set negative a minus x. So we'll solve this one, minus a minus x greater than equals to 0. So we have negative a greater than equals to x, or x less than or equals to negative a. So we have negative a here, that's why we have negative a here. And this one, we have x less than or equals, that's why our graph is going to the left, right? And because of no symbol at the front of the set, that's why our graph is going up. For the domain, the smallest value is negative infinity, and the highest value it can take is negative a. And for the range, the smallest value is 0, and the highest value is infinity. For the final graph, we have fx equals to negative set a minus x, and I will include a minus x greater than equals to 0. So a greater than equals to x, x less than or equals to a. So first one, we have a here, that's why I have a over here. Second one, I have less than or equal here, that's why our graph is going to the left. Why our graph is going down? Because of negative at the front of the set. For the domain, the smallest value is negative infinity, the highest value is a. And for the range, the smallest value is negative infinity and the highest value is 0. Now we will look at three examples. So first one example 5.6. Sketch a grid graph of the following functions and find the domain and range. Question A, we have fx equals to x minus 3 set, and this one obviously we know by now, this one is set function, right? So first one, what we do here is we look at the domain. So we solve x minus 3 greater than equals to 0 and x greater than or equals to 3. So we know. So from the domain, we know our graph direction. So first one is going to the right. Why? Because of greater than or equals to 3. Second one, it is going up because of no symbol at the front of the set. Third one, we look for the starting point, right? So starting point we can take from here. So we know our starting point x should be 3. We substitute x equals to 3. We substitute, so what is our value of y? How to calculate this one, or fx? See, so we substitute f3 equals to 3 minus 3. This one we have 0, so fx should be 0. So we have our starting point now. Then we sketch the graph. So we label the x, we label the x, right? So our starting point is 3, 0. 3, 0 is somewhere here, and our graph is to the right and up. So this is our graph, right? So we label our graph fx equals to x minus 3, and this one is 3. Done. The sketch. Now let's find what is domain. So domain from here, so we have 3 to infinity, and what is range? Zero to infinity. Done with question A. Now we move to question B. Question B, we have fx equals to negative set x plus 5. So this one is obviously set function. So first one, domain. So x plus 5 greater than or equals to 0, so x greater than or equals to negative 5, right? Second one, direction, right? Going to the right, and because of negative here, it's going down, right? Starting point, check for the third one. Starting point right? So we know x is negative 5. You substituted x negative 5 into the original function, you should have y equals to 0. That is our starting point. And now we sketch the graph. So this one. Label this one x. Don't forget to label your axis. This one is fx. Starting point is negative 5. So let's say negative 5 is here, and the graph is going to the right and down. Right and down, right? So this one we put negative 5. We label the graph as fx equals to negative x plus 5. So from the sketch, we notice that we have y-intercept here. So we have to find y-intercept. So how to find y-intercepts? X0, y equals to, substitute x equals to 0 into the function, we should have y equals to negative 5. Right? Negative root 5, negative root 5. Right, so domain, for domain of this function, so domain is negative 5 to infinity, and range is negative infinity to 0. Done. Question B, final one, question C. So we have here fx equals to 3 minus set. So first one, this one is set function. So first one, we check the domain. Domain is x greater than or equals to 0. Second one, we check the direction. So the graph is going to the right. Second one is because of negative here, the graph is going down. Right? Third point, we check the starting point. So starting point is when x equals to 0, y equals to 3. So we know our starting point is x equals to 0, y equals to 3. Let me sketch the graph. So this one is x, this one is fx. Starting point is 0, 3. So 0, 3 is up here somewhere. And the graph is going to the right and going down. So going up, going down. This one. And here we label this one as 3. And from the sketch, we label the graph as. So fx equals to 3 minus x. So from the sketch, we notice the graph has x-intercepts. So we have to find x-intercepts. So x-intercept is when y equals to 0, x equals to, so you substitute y equals to 0 in the original function, should have y, or some of you may write this one fx equals to 0. It's okay. So you should have x equals to 9. So this one equals to 9. Right, that is the graph. And then finally, what is the domain? So domain is 0 to infinity, and what is range? Range is negative infinity to 3. Done. So we now finish set function.